CBS News commissioned a survey by the Opinion Research Corporation into public attitudes toward homosexuality. We discovered that Americans consider homosexuality more harmful to society than adultery, abortion, or prostitution.
And if we catch you and vow with a homosexual, your parents are going to know about it first. And you will be caught. Don't think you won't be caught. Because this is one thing you cannot get away with. This is one thing that if you don't get caught by us, you'll be caught by yourself. And the rest of your life will be a living hell.
Most Americans are repelled by the mere notion of homosexuality. The CBS News survey shows that 2 out of 3 Americans look upon homosexuals with disgust, discomfort, or fear.
Dawn hours of June 28, 1969, police carried out a surprise raid on the Stonewall Inn, located in the heart of New York City. The inn served as a safe haven for people of the LGBT community throughout the late 1960s. Originally opened by 3 mafia members in 1966, the popular gay bar was widely attended by drag queens, LGBT youth, and transgender individuals who were in search of a space where they could be themselves without fear of judgment or prosecution. In New York City at the time, laws were in place barring the solicitation of homosexual relations. In addition, anti-cross-dressing laws required that people wear at least 3 items of their assigned gender's clothing. As such, the Stonewall Inn and other gay bars were raided frequently by police. Bribes given to police officers by the owners of Stonewall meant that the employees and patrons of the inn were usually tipped off before raids would occur. However, this night was different. Although rumors of a raid were passed around, there was no official tip-off by police. Even still, at around 1:20 a.m. on Saturday, June 28th, police entered the bar and began to arrest and harass patrons who were not complying with orders or who were in violation of the law. As violators were aggressively forced into paddy wagons, the understandably angry patrons began to gather. After being hit on the head with a police baton, a butch lesbian identified by some as Stormy DeLarvery seemed to incite a full-blown riot with a simple call to action. Why don't you do something? It was after these 5 words that chaos ensued. Tired of the discrimination and hate they faced, the overwhelmingly LGBT crowd, which had grown to hundreds of people, began to throw pennies, glass bottles, garbage cans, and even bricks and rocks at the police. Chants of "We shall overcome" and "Gay power" rang out as the crowd became increasingly agitated. The following riots, which took place in front of the bar on Christopher Street as well as in nearby Christopher Park, lasted by some accounts for 6 days. The incident gained massive media attention and is believed by some to have been the spark that fueled the modern gay rights movement. On June 28, 1970, on the 1-year anniversary of the Stonewall Inn riots, the first gay pride parade was held in New York. The event was called Christopher Street Liberation Day and has continued ever since as an annual reminder of what happened that night at the Stonewall Inn. After the riots, the first gay rights organizations were formed. It is because of the work of those organizations and LGBT activists such as Marsha P. Johnson and Sylvia Rivera that the widespread opinion of LGBT people has changed for the better. Homosexuality was decriminalized across the United States in 2003, and the Supreme Court legalized gay marriage in 2015. The monumental 1969 riots at Stonewall Inn will forever be remembered, not only as a day of protest and violence, but as a catalyst that ultimately inspired the modern gay liberation movement and changed millions of LGBT Americans' lives for the better.
Looking at the moon, but I